I don't have to port with him.
It's a vlog. Hi and see you welcome to Seating Films, it's a vlog. Alright, this is going to be a bit of a rush vlog because I haven't got much time. But I'm currently using my PlayStation 9 because my HD camera has ran out of juice and I should be charging it, really. Damn you, Stevie T. Anyways, I'm currently using my PlayStation 9, but don't worry, I'll know my editing skills. I'll make sure it's in widescreen and make myself not look fat, because knowing the PlayStation 9 camera is normally 4.3. Alright, I'm rambling on. Right, let's get on with some stuff. Now, as you may know by my Sony Vegas skills, if you might have followed me on Facebook, I've currently done some really good tests, and I'm quite pleased with myself with using Sony Vegas. Sony Vegas is a really good thing, and most people like Defy, Space Godzilla, if you may or not have known, have upgraded to Sony Vegas, and I'm loving Sony Vegas. Enough about Sony Vegas, I'm rambling on. Right, I want to do a quick mini review on the YouTube layout. The YouTube layout is really good, but I just don't like the comment section and plus the save to favourites, because normally with the saving to favourites, it's normally a button for favourites, but I just don't particularly like the whole save to favourites, what I need to get used to. Plus the comment section is a bit dull because it's all muddled up. You know, making sure like this comment's for this person and all that. At least you got the app reply and all that. And also, I don't mind, it's a good thing for those people with no one-star rating on their videos no more, which I'm quite pleased. But I like the whole dislike and like, you know, with the whole dislike and like, even though it's copying Facebook. But it gives the YouTuber to know how much feedback they're getting on their videos, which is quite good. But overall, the YouTube layout is good, but some people need to get used to because they're all criticising it and all that. Right, a mini review on the Doctor Who episode. Now, as you may have known, on BBC, or those people not into Doctor Who, I just love Doctor Who, and I loved the first episode of the fifth series. And I'm sorry to say though that I don't particularly like David Tennant. Now, sure, David Tennant is a really good actor, I don't mind him, but he did really good work on series 2, 3, and 4. But Matt Smith, he did a really good job, and I can't wait to see what other stuff you get to do on that series. And I just like to say bravo on the first episode, and I'm looking forward to what you do on that series, and I'm just loving Doctor Who, and I can't wait to watch it every Saturday now. For those people in America, hope you're looking forward to it, those fans in America of Doctor Who on BBC America. It's going to be a worth episode waiting for, and I hope you guys enjoy it in America, which will be coming out in 2 weeks. So yeah, I'm just loving Doctor Who at the moment, because the first episode is just mind-blowing. Right, quickly on pickups. Now, as you may know, it's Easter. I'll just wash in my Easter thing, which is I've got an Easter egg from my mum, because normally for Easter, I normally get an egg and £5 from my grandma. I just want to say happy Easter to all of you. And I didn't want it to feel left out on because at the moment my current game stores are doing like a sale, and I picked up something from Game Station. And I have picked up Tatsunoko vs Capcom, because normally it used to be 30-odd quid, because it is quite expensive pre-owned, and I found it in a cheap price for £15. Excuse me, I'm burping because I'm talking too much. But yeah, £15, it's brilliant price. And for those people that needed a good fighting game on the Nintendo Wii, this is quite good. Even though that you might not know much about the Tatsunoko series company and all that, but overall it's a good game. Mainly I got this for so I can play with Defy, Sergio, and Space Godzilla, my friends on YouTube. So I can't wait to play this with you guys, and even though it's a bit late, but I did say that I'll try and get it soon as, and I got it for a really good price of £15. Now, if you might have known by my old videos, I had a copy of Mad Worlds, and I kind of got it again because stupid old me, Stevie T, kind of traded it in for no apparent reason. And I should not have really, because Mad Worlds is a really, really good game, and I do recommend it from the Nintendo Wii from last year in 2009. But it's just that I picked it up again for £5, as you can see. You can get it quite cheap nowadays, because it used to be £10, but every sale that they always do it, they always do it for a fiver, so I was lucky enough to pick it up again. So enough about that. Right, games I'm currently playing. I've been currently playing on Pokemon Silver, because Pokemon Silver is just brilliant, and I get a chance to play Pokemon Silver, as you may know in my unboxing, because I never actually played Pokemon Silver. But I'm currently on Goldenrod. I'm currently defeated the Team Rocket leader on Goldenrod Sea at the radio tower, and I'm currently on Route 45-ish and stuff like that. So I'm looking forward to trying and complete this game, and it is just brilliant now. So, and the Pokewalker, I know it's a bit of a naff thing, but I do actually walk with this, and it's just brilliant now, and I can't wait to walk more with this, because I love my walking, because I do walk to town, and I use this a lot and stuff like that. Also about Battlefield Bad Company, I've been playing a bit more on Battlefield Bad Company 2, because Battlefield Bad Company is a brilliant game, and, you know, I know I've been dissing a lot about Modern Warfare lately because of an issue that I had, and it gone over the top with this whole Modern Warfare scenario, as you may have saw on my site. But overall, I just don't particularly like Modern Warfare. I'm currently level 15 or 16 on Battlefield Bad Company 2. And also, not only that, I've been playing on, as you may have known by my gameplay, I bought Mega Man 10, and I'm currently need to do 4 Robot Masters, and I'm done that game. It's quite a good game. I do recommend Mega Man 10 to anyone on any system, and for those people that need an easier Mega Man game, and it's a really good easy Mega Man game. And I'm quite enjoying it with those, because I never actually played Mega Man, as you may know. Right. A bit about Modern Warfare. Currently this weekend, to mark on the whole launch and success on Modern Warfare 2 map packs, Infinity Ward are doing like a double EXP weekend, in case you guys may have not known that, or those guys that are playing it might have realised they got double the points because it's double EXP weekends. Plus, not only that, they're giving away a free avatar thing for your head, which is night vision goggles. Because they're doing it for free, that used to be 240 Microsoft points, and they're currently doing it for free as a promotional for their success on their first map pack. And for those of you that are PS3 and PC owners, you have to wait a bit longer because, you know, they're concentrating on the Xbox 360 and stuff, which is quite good. I want to quickly say about work, because I'm currently got promoted on work. Because as you may know, I'm currently on break on my work, and I've got 2 weeks left on my break. And currently, I got promoted again, because the reason why I got promoted, because they like my work, they like my how-to videos, they love how I do on YouTube, because they kind of discover my YouTube, and they want me to use my knowledge, because I'm really good with my animation, and they asked me to, because they currently got a mascot, and they want me to animate their mascot for their work placement, because they got like a mascot for their to symbolize their work placement, you know, like Sonic is symboled for their Sega company. And they asked me to animate their mascot and stuff like that, which is cool. I got good promotion for that. And also, they watch my videos on my how-to videos, and they love my technology, what I do, and they want me to do like some how-to sheets. They want me to do how-to sheets on like cameras and iPods and all that kind of stuff. I'm pleased though that I get to actually work and not get bored, because most of the time I've been renaming files, and they got me promoted again because they just like my work even more, and they really want to use all my knowledge on gaming, computers, and my know-it-all and animations and all that. So I'm pleased though to be promoted. Right, I want to say quickly about videos. Now, there's not much videos to do until late April, because I won't be doing much videos lately, because currently the Left 4 Dead 2 DLC has been delayed, because they announce on Send You a Message, which is an Xbox Live series, or I'm rambling on again, but basically Valve delayed their Left 4 Dead 2 DLC, which was meant to come out at late March, so it's been delayed until late April. So I'll be getting that at late April, so expect some gameplay of that soon. I might say that on another vlog or something. And also to mention about my DS and Wii collection. Currently, I will be doing my DS and Wii collection. It's just that I really wanted to get Mad World back from my Wii collection, and also I'm waiting for 2DS games to come out, which is my Game & Watch collection and WarioWare DIY. And I can't wait to do a mega unboxing, because I'm currently saving up for stuff at 30th of April, in case those of you that followed my site. Also, I was going to try and do a chat roulette video of me playing Battlefield Bad Company 2, but I didn't get a good caption software for my PC to record stuff on the website. So in case any of you knows about a cool capturing stuff on a website, let me know, and I'll do a really good video on a chat roulette video, because as you may know, I got some good views on a chat roulette video. So anyways, I'm rabbiting on. So anyways, keep up to date with my Twitter, Facebook, and site. Anyways, I better go now. See you from CT Films.